board back then and doing things. And you know, I never wanted to, people say, well, why did you give that song away? Why did you let so-and-so cut it? Why didn't y'all cut it? I just had never looked at it like that, Sandy. I just had never been able to look at it like that. Sherry used to tell me, she said, Marcia, thank you for being so generous with your songs. But you know, I've never looked at it like that. I've always looked at it like that was my little thing that I could do. It was like preaching a message. You know, why would you want to keep it to yourself? You know, you don't mind if another pastor hears it, he preaches it, and gets that word out. I never minded that. But getting back to the business, they recorded several of my songs and have done really well with them. And they've given me 4 number ones over the years, and that's just like, bam. Just saying that to just so show what God can do. But I had, they recorded Nail It to the Cross. And they were working on an album, probably, Lord, this was a long time ago. This was back right after my last child was born in 99. They were looking for songs, and I sent this thing to her. And the song, the reason I think the Lord has used is anything to God for God, Brother Dan, is because it is pure word. You know where it is. Jeremiah 32:27, and then it's over there in Genesis also when Abraham and Sarah were expecting Isaac. But you know, whatever it is, when I have a problem, and I think one thing, I wouldn't go back to my younger days for nothing. I don't like what age is doing to me. Me and Sandy have talked about plenty of that this week. She has talked a lot this week. Can y'all believe that? I know it's uncharacteristic. But we were talking, I wouldn't take nothing for what I have learned about God and His faithfulness in my life. I wouldn't take anything for it. I hate that my husband has gone through 14 heart caths and had open heart surgery at the age of 48. I hate the fact that I've missed over 3 years of work and it put us in near financial ruin over the years. I hate it that I've had to deal with a chronic pain issue for about 9 years. But I tell you what, I've served a faithful God and He has brought me through it. And I'm here tonight in the West Anderson Church of God to encourage you and to tell you that it will make you stronger. Things will make you stronger. And I believe in this song. It says in Jeremiah 32:27, God asks a question. And when God asks a question, He don't want the answer. He just wants you to think about it. He knows the answer. He already knows what the answer is. But He wants us to think about it. He wants us to think about it. And He said, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me? These days when I have a problem come up, I act a little different than I did, say, 10 years ago, 15 years ago. I know now that I don't even need to waste any time trying to figure out what I'm going to do about it. That's natural. It's human nature. But you know, God doesn't need our building blocks or our multiple choices to know what to do about the problems in our life. He tells us in Jeremiah 33:3 that call unto me and I will answer thee and show thee great, great and mighty things. Not just a band-aid solution to your problem, but He can handle it. He can do it all at once. But you know what? If He does it little by little, that's still deliverance to me. That's been my little nugget the last couple of weeks. One more scripture thing for you. When Joshua was going into Canaan and he was trying to conquer the territory, the Lord told him, He said that, you know, go up into them and I will be with you and I will deliver you, for this is the promise unto the children of Israel. But He said, I will not drive out all of your enemies in 1 year. He said, because the land would become desolate. You know, God knows. Sometimes if He cleared my slate of all my problems, do you think that my prayer life would be as long and maybe as be as intense as it is? He knows. He knows people. I just want to let you know tonight, for all your questions, there's really only one. Is anything too hard for God? Waiting on the end.
answer. He has a question for you.
I had lived a life.
queen.